Hello, my name is Suspienko. In this video I will talk about the Schrade Extreme Survival Knife. This is an older knife made in USA. We see that on the packaging. It was a good find on a flea market locally here in North Georgia. $25, it was already reduced, and this is not the later made by Taylor brand, made in China variants. This is the original one that is made in USA. There is not much around online about the history. I can remember that I saw those knives back then, like in the 90s or something like that, a long time ago, but I can't remember exactly what kind of variations they did make. And they made a couple of variants that I see, but exactly about the history, when it was made and all that, I cannot say too much about that. So the boxing material is a simple clear plastic. We see on top the Schrade Extreme Survival, and again this is a older variant. The made in USA, the newer variant on that Schrade Extreme Survival name are made in China. They look different, and for sure the quality is way less good as well. So this is made in USA. We have a blackened solid steel hammer. We have a durable belt loop on the sheet, the textured rubber handle, and the blade has all around cutting edges, different ones from serrations to fine tooth saw to saw blade. And on the back side, the packaging look like that. We see the barcode and the limited lifetime warranty from Imperial Schrade. There is even the Ellenville address from USA, and below we have a bit of paperwork too. The box, of course, is not in a brand new condition. The knife is. That was quite likely quite a while in storage. So we see we have a rubber handle. Quite grippy, and we have here a lanyard hole, wood with a bit of wiggle fit for a paracord. Back then, of course, that was less common around, and this is a tension pin that they put in through the tang of the blade, and with that big heavy solid hammer pommel there, quite a solid material. Finish on the metal parts is a parkerized finish, like for the military. Schrade did do a lot of military contracts back then. Then we have the blade. It's the shape of the M7 that Schrade did make too. We see already here a bit markings from the spring that holds it in the sheet. That was not on there as I got it. That was brand new in the box and quite likely never before in the sheet. We see we have the cutting edge starting here, serrations, 3/4 of the blade, and then we have a fine edge. The fine edge is pretty nicely done too, but over the years it is not 100% there. I need to resharpen it a little bit, as this is a using knife. We have on top then really fine serrations there. They did apparently say in advertising that is like a file, but these are just serrations, really fine ones. That creates a bit of problem at the very tip. I'm not sure if the camera will see it, but they put the serrations, the tiny serrations, all the way to the tip there, so the tip is relatively fragile. This of course has a top switch like the M7, so it's more like a dagger style and less of a pry bar kinda blade tip, so it's more fine. Then we have from here on all the way to the end saw blade. This is not free floating, it has not the angled tooths either, so that is a basic saw blade from back then. It's sure gonna work. The part until here is a bit sticky, and then here it's gonna get free floated. If you use that, as we see, it is a backward motion that is cleverly made, because if it would be a forward motion, maybe you could slip and cut yourself. And if you saw like that, you always go a bit in an angle. I just overdo it now, but if you get a bit more of an angle cut, that makes it more easier free float, so you reach the part here where it then gets free floated anyhow. So all in all, quality wise, really nice. The sheet is great too. We see we have a belt loop, pretty big back then for the military belts, a nice riveted on, absolute durable construction. The loop is in the same way with the snap. The sheet is a two-part plastic, feels pretty good. It's not a fragile one, sure feels better than a Chinese one that I made that is completely riveted together as well. We have the slots on the side and on the bottom. Back then, that was long time ago, Molly was not around, but the slots still give you quite a good leashing points on gear if you want that, and the thickness is not too bad on the sheet either. Then we have here that part that looks like a Molly strap, and as we open the snap there, we have a nice sharpening stone. This one is brand new too, never been used. So because of the flatness of the sheet, you can put it down, you can easily hold it, and then sharpen the knife. So all in all, pretty nice done. The sheet is for left and right hand use. You can put in the knife in any way you want, and we have the secure snap there. It's not gonna wiggle too much, that's just the flap here. So that's pretty good made for back then. Maybe the 80s or 90s as they made that. That is sure a knife that would work pretty well more in a dagger style, or point is about the knife tip, the knife point that is a bit on the weak side, so it's not a pry bar as a knife shouldn't be anyhow. But all in all, I like it a lot. It's already a collectible, of course, because it's that old, and quite likely not too many were made over in Switzerland and Europe. I never saw that. I just saw it at dealer shows like the EVA, where Schrade did exhibit. Even at the last year, as they were still in business, they did celebrate their anniversary, and pretty nice people, also from Ireland. And then the next year they were pretty much gone and bankrupt. That fast it can go, that did teach quite a lesson. So all the nice Schrade knives made in USA were gone and were replaced with way less quality made in China products. They look the same, they feel the same pretty much, but the quality for sure is less. So that is how that is. But this one again is a nice older made in USA one. So that much about the Schrade Extreme Survival Fixed Blade.